Thank you very much, Lakshmi. Thank you. And I would like to thank the others, Ankita, Amina, who welcomed me in the airways, and your dear principal, Mr. Gigi, for your warm words of welcome. So I'm extremely happy to be here. Delighted, exactly. That's what I would like to say, to be part of this very special club. And I should thank Mr. Abhilash and Dr. Jayashree. See, they're the ones I know, right? They're the ones who invited me. So I'm familiar with their names. There must be other names behind this. But I should also mention two other names that I heard about. That is Mr. Suresh and Mr. Satish, who are alumni and who I heard are the brains behind it. This is a wonderful initiative, CCC, CET Communication Club. CCC, CET, CCC. And I'm very happy that this has happened. It's a wonderful initiative. And let me tell you, I believe that this should have happened much earlier. This was something, like they say, this is an accident waiting to happen. This is a club waiting to happen. Only thing is, it should have happened much earlier. I'll tell you the reason. See, I have heard from many sources, for many people, that college engineering students in Kerala, I'm not talking about the rest of the state, the engineering, and I'm not even talking about the students in other colleges. It's more or less the same problem, but engineering colleges produce students, or I don't even need to say they produce students, the engineering students are very good academically, but when it comes to speaking, when it comes to communicating, when it comes to an interview, when it comes to a campus selection interview, they are found wanting. And especially with CET, this should not happen, because it's all of you are CET. I can openly talk about CET, the elite status of CET, how the moment you hear somebody is from CET, you say, ah, CET, because CET is very special. I have a special relationship with CET in the sense that my brother studied in CET long back. My sister studied in CET. She did electrical engineering when there were just a handful of girls doing electrical engineering. My son, rather recently, has been a CET product. He did industrial engineering. But that's not just it. It is an elite college. You have to say that. And government colleges, government engineering colleges attract the cream of the students, CET especially. You get the academically brilliant students. So here you have a college that has got students who are academically brilliant. You'd expect them to go all the way and do wonderfully at every step. They do that until there's a point where this final hurdle, when it is this interview, when you have to talk, when you have to communicate, when you have to take your ideas across, when you have to tell people something, they are diffident, they hesitate, they are not confident, they are not able to express themselves. Not everybody, all right? I'm not talking about everybody, but I'm talking about quite a number of students. So this communication club is very important. So we feel, and it is especially to do with English. So with apologies to the principal who said that, not apologies, I just want to say that this club is for all kinds of communication, but I think special importance must be given to communication in English. Other communication is also there, the written, the verbal, the getting people out of their inhibitions and so on. But I'm going to primarily to stress upon the need to be proficient in English. Why do students need to be proficient in English? For a very simple reason. That is because English is very important. English is the most important language in the world. We have a population of about 7.5 billion people, and 1.5 billion people speak English. Maximum number of people in the world speak English. In fact, English has overtaken Mandarin. Up to 2018, Mandarin Chinese. Now that was the most important. It was spoken by the maximum number of people. But that is because it was in China. China is very the most populous country anyway. English is spoken all over the world. And English has now overtaken it. Also, you must remember that only a small percentage of this huge number that is speaking English are native speakers. The rest are just speaking English. Why and how did this happen? Why did this, you know, this linguistic supremacy happen that English, a small country like UK, where English started, has taken over the whole world? Well, I could go on about this and then you will ask me to shut up and move. So I'm not going to do that. I'll just tell you that's very, very important for these various reasons. It is now the link language in the world. It is the link language in India. Much as you might find people trying to say Hindi must be the link language. No, it is only English. It is English that is the link language in India. It is English that is the link language in the world. It is the language of higher education. Your books are all in English. English medium. You know, it is the language of science. It is the language of technology. It is the language of the internet. You're forever downloading apps. You are sending WhatsApp messages left, right, and center. And you are forwarding this, that, and so on. They're all in English, mostly in English. And so English is there everywhere. And therefore, we should be better at English. Now, what has happened is, in fact, we should actually be grateful. I hope nobody will be annoyed with me for saying this, that it is in the English who colonized us and not the French. Imagine if the French had colonized us and they left French behind. What good would it do for us if we learned French? We would be good only in France. But the English came. Thankfully, they left. But they left behind something very good, and that is the English language. It is our luck that they left us behind. And so what has happened is, English is here, but there is a reluctance among people, students, to study English. We have English medium schools. We have English everywhere, actually. But there is a sort of snobbery attached to English. Some people believe that if you speak English, you are a cut above the rest. You are, you know that word, the expression, they say ash bush person. You are one of that kind. No, if you think like that, then you are sadly mistaken, because it is only a language. There is no inferiority, superiority in languages. Every language is equally important. But English is especially important. I told you the reasons why. So we need to say, like, all animals are equal, but some are more equal than others. All languages are important, but some are more important than others. And one is the most important, and that is English. So one has got to learn English. And what you find, what I wanted to tell you was that there is a kind of reverse snobbery happening. If somebody speaks in English, that person is hushed up. They stop the person from speaking in English. And I know for a fact this happened in university college. There was a boy who was speaking English. The next day, the union members surrounded him and said, Meelal, one word of English in Malayalam, one word of English from your mouth, and we will break your legs. So that is the kind of threat that was given. And the same ones who threatened later regretted not learning English. So what I want to say is that when there is this opportunity to study English, when it is there in schools, compulsorily there, you, because it's coming easily, you reject it, you ignore it. You should know Malayalam. I will always say that you must know Malayalam, you have to know Malayalam, your language, it is imperative you know Malayalam. But you need to know this language also. There's no harm. You should. It's good for you. You must have heard about the importance of a second language, about a rat that was running with a mother rat running with a little baby rat, and the rat and a cat pounces on them. So the mother rat turns and says, bow, bow. And the cat looks frightened and runs away. So the mother rat turns to the baby rat and says, see, this is the importance of a second language. you should know a second language. Now, I'm not asking you to become, to learn Bobo and so on, but you need this language to, you need to master this language, or at least be proficient in this language to do well in your, to do well as far as your future is concerned. So, so what you need to do, so what, and I must also tell you that there are different kinds of schools. We have the elite schools, we have the English medium schools, where English is the norm, but even those students deliberately reject English. It happens in class, but they won't speak outside. Then there is another group that is who come from this, who have this from the villages, you know, the government schools, schools which are not as privileged as the other schools, where also there is English, where the students unfortunately are not exposed to English. They are taught English in Malayalam. They are taught enough to pass the exam. It is like the way I study French. I can only translate a bit. I can't understand French. I cannot speak in French. So you, there must be a point in knowing a language. Your language should be used. Language should be used for communication. All right. So what I think should be done, this should be done at the school level, actually, where the teachers, the students should cooperate, and there should be a concerted effort to make them learn Malayalam, English equally well by making them communicate, all right? But right now here, that's all over. You're all, you have passed school and you're now in college. So we are thinking of, we are talking about what can be done now. Let's forget about what should have been done, what I hope will be done, but let's look at what can be done for you. So as your principal said, we really do need communication skills. We need skills, as you said, listening skills, hearing skills, reading skills, writing skills in both languages, very important. But what I would like to say, what we need to do is to master it now. It's not too late. It's never too late to learn a language. There's this famous writer, Joseph Conrad, I don't know if they've heard of him. He did not know a word of English till he was 21 years old. And then he learned English. You won't be on his own. You'll be shocked to know how he learned English through Shakespeare's plays. He learned English painstakingly and went on to write wonderful books, classics. So it is, we need not become Conrad. We need not become Joseph Conrad and write all those classics. But we can, what I mean to say is it's never too late to start. You can start even now. So this is where your club becomes important. So what I would like you to do is, let's see that you must shed your inhibitions. This is the problem with, I think people, what I heard is the problem of people in, when they are interviewed from Kerala. They are very shy. They are inhibited. They don't come out. They don't speak. They're very intelligent. Academically, they are right up there, but they can't speak out. How do you do that? You're scared. So that is where this club will come in handy. Help you speak. Help you get over your inhibition. You're scared to make mistakes. It doesn't matter. What does it matter if you make mistakes? We all make mistakes. We make mistakes and then we realize it's a mistake and we grow. I remember when I was small in the second standard, I was on a seesaw and there was this seesaw where I was thin. I was up on. Yes? It's time?
No, please carry on.
Yes, okay. I just got 2 more minutes to, I'm conscious of time. Yeah. Please carry on. Yes. So because it is virtual, you really don't know how it is, who is watching, who is listening. You know, I'm talking about communication, listening ability, speaking. Here I'm doing the speaking. You have to do the listening. And I know that 10 minutes is about all that anyone can, the attention span of people. I really don't know, because after that we take off and go somewhere else. And now I cannot even say, I can just see a few of you, but the rest of you are somewhere there, I know. So I'll just quickly wind up with what I want you to do. And what I want to tell you is about my seesaw thing. I was the second standard coming straight into the, didn't study first standard, education incomplete. So that must be the, so any force you find you can put to my, you know, incomplete education. I went straight to the second standard. I was just learning English. So I was up there and this fatter friend was down. So she was asking me to push down. So she said, you did like this. She's asking me to say, she meant you do like this, but she said, you did like this. And she was showing this action. So from the top, I did like this. And I said, I am didding. I'm didding. And she, I should have said, I am doing, but because she said, you did, I said, I'm didding. And my sister heard this and it's the biggest joke. And even now they tell, ask me, how are you didding and so on. But what I want to tell you is that because of that mistake, I did not stop speaking English. I realized that was a mistake. So you make mistakes and you have to keep on seeing that those mistakes are gone. So how do you do that? So what you need to do is, have this club will help you. And please, this club, I hope you have regular meetings. I was in a college, so I know that you have 50 clubs, you said. This may be the 51st or I don't know what, 51st, 52nd, whatever, any number of clubs. My college, All Saints College, had a huge number of clubs. We would have a wonderful inauguration. We would have a fabulous valedictory function and nothing in the middle, right? Hardly anything. So that should not happen. We have an inauguration. I would want you to regularly have meetings where you get people to come out of their shells, to speak, to give them opportunities to talk, to discuss, to express themselves in English, in Malayalam also. But I think what you need, if you want them to perform well in campus selection and if you want them to grow in the corporate world and so on, you need to be proficient in English. So forgive me if I'm always talking about English. I also mean other languages, but I feel that English is at this point very, very important and you must not lose sight of that. So you have to, you improve by talking. You improve by listening. Listen to good programs in English, BBC programs. YouTube will have many programs. Watch good programs and talk to your friends in English. Don't allow this communication thing to be only during the meetings of the communication club. It should happen all the time. If possible, occasionally try to think in English. So read in English, read a lot of good books. That's when your language gets better and better unconsciously through enjoyment. You really get very proficient in a language, all right? So read, write, listen, talk, argue, do all these things, have great fun through your club. It is all the students who are going to be behind it, as the principal said, and I hope they will see to it that all the members of the club are very confident people and take CET right up there. So I would like to wish each and every one of you all the best, and I hope the club does fabulously well, and each of you also do wonderfully in your careers and in your life. Thank you very much.